Good evening, and thanks for joining us tonight. For the past several weeks, really many months, years, I felt like a little kid in the backseat of a car on a long journey, and I just wanted to continually ask, are we there yet? Well, at 12:33 a.m., we will be there. Of course, there, Ultima Thule, according to one of my astronomy apps, is located about 4.1 billion miles that way. And at the speed of light, a bit more than 6 hours and 7 minutes travel time. And by the way, given the Parker Solar Probe and New Horizons mission, when asked where APL is, I simply point out that we are strategically located between the sun and the Kuiper Belt. More seriously, let me welcome everyone here tonight. We have with us the Honorable John Culberson, Congressman from Texas, who serves on the Committee on Appropriations and is chairman of the Subcommittee on Commerce, Justice, and Science. He's been an incredible space supporter. Congressman. I also want to welcome our NASA colleagues, who join us today not in any official capacity, but because of their love of science and their dedication to this very special mission. We applaud all of you. And of course, we're very fortunate that the NASA Administrator has given permission for Thomas Zurbuchen, the Associate Administrator for the Science Mission Directorate, to join us tonight as well. So, great. Thomas, where are you here? Thomas, thank you. I also want to welcome our New Horizons teammates from multiple organizations who are spending this New Year's Eve at APL and who have spent the past many evenings and days here at the lab. Our PI, of course, Alan Stern from the Southwest Research Institute, who's been involved with the exploration of Pluto and the Kuiper Belt for close to 3 decades now. Really remarkable. And I want to welcome the members of the international media. Thank you for sharing this voyage of discovery with the world. And a special shout out to the Washington Post, which characterized the celebration tonight as, and I quote, what is perhaps the solar system's nerdiest New Year's party. All I have to say to that is, well, our party has a rock star. In fact, given the scientists and engineers who have made this mission possible, our party has a lot of rock stars. And speaking of rock stars, welcome to all of our APL staff members who are here because they directly support the New Horizons mission or are just excited to support the team. And of course, welcome to all the families, friends, and fans joining us this evening. While we are proud of the 70 spacecraft and nearly 300 instruments APL has built since the dawn of the space age, New Horizons holds a dear place in our hearts as an intrepid and persistent little explorer, as well as a great photographer. Remember the heart of Pluto? Now, the exploration of the Kuiper Belt marks another first for all of us, NASA, the nation, and the world, as Ultima Thule is the farthest, most primitive object ever explored. This flyby also bookends one of history's greatest explorations as we usher in the 50th anniversary year of the Apollo 11 moon landing. You know, a thread of inspiration runs from the Apollo astronauts to the New Horizons team, connecting generations who will remember where they were when they saw brand new worlds up close for the first time. This milestone, flying past a new world on New Year's Day, should imbue all of us with a sense of awe and hope for our future. In fact, at least in my mind, it is a profound demonstration of how humankind, working together on a global scale can, as we aspire to at APL, be bold, do great things, and make the world a better place. And I think that is partly why there is so much enthusiasm around the world about New Horizons and this historic flyby of Ultima Thule. So thank you for joining us in this great exploration, this celebration of scientific achievement, and of course, Happy New Year.